So many people were asking for this switch, and now here it is. This is the brand new UniFi Pro Max 16 PoE switch. This is a 16 port switch that has 2.5 gigabit ports. It has PoE plus output, and yes, it even has Etherlighting. Plus, it's a small form factor that can sit on your desk, or it can be wall mounted out of the box, and it can also be rack mounted with an optional rack mount accessory. So today is May 1st, 2024. I received this switch yesterday, and it goes live in the Ubiquiti store tomorrow. So I really haven't had a chance to fully put it through its paces yet. In fact, I don't even know the MSRP, though I assume it is gonna be cheaper than the 24 port Pro Max PoE switch, which is $799. Future Chris popping in here, I now have the MSRP on this switch. The PoE variant of this model is going to be $479. This is US pricing. But they're also gonna have a non-PoE version for $279. Okay, now back to the video. So in this video, we're gonna do an old-fashioned unboxing and setup, and I will give you my first impressions along the way. All right, I cannot wait to dig into this one, so let's get started. All right, so looking at the box, first thing we notice is that it has 16 ports and looks like two SFPs. I'm gonna assume those are SFP plus ports. We'll see when we dig into it. And this is the USW Pro Max 16 PoE. Okay, oh, it has a, all right, I'm already seeing something interesting. Ooh, it's tiny. I mean, it's not tiny tiny, but compared to the rack mount ones, it's tiny. Anything else? All right, so one thing I'm seeing right off the bat, this did say that it is wall mountable out of the box, and it does come with a template with a little built-in level for wall mounting. So I guess it is wall mountable out of the box. Let's see here. All right, oh, look at this thing. All right, I love this little switch already. Look, compared to like a full like One U device, you could see that it is significantly smaller. Yeah, so this is a good device for like a desktop form factor. Now it has these two notches on the bottom. I wonder if those have to do with the wall mounting. And then as far as the ports in the front, we have, it looks like 12 of the ports are standard gigabit, and these last four ports over here are 2.5 gigabit. And then yes, these are 10 gig SFP plus cages on the side. So we've got a couple little notches here. This is probably for the rack mount accessory. I'm gonna open that up in just a moment because I do have the rack mount for this device as well. And it doesn't have a standard power switch. Look at that. It says input 54 volt 3.9 amp. Let's open up the accessories. I think that'll tell us a little bit more about this switch. Oh yeah, big power brick. So the reason they can make it small is because they don't have to have this inside the chassis, right? This is now on the exterior. Then we've got a power cable, and it looks like we've got some rubber feet. What's this little white thing here? What is this little guy? I should probably read the setup guide. Not sure. Oh, you know what this is? I bet this is for popping off these little things here. Oh yeah, look at that. Okay, it's like a guitar pick, basically. Woo, all right, cool. I should pick those up so I don't lose them. Okay, then we have some drywall anchors and screws, and we have a couple of rack mount ears, but how is it supposedly, that's all that comes in here. Now, how is it wall mountable out of the box, though? Oh, all right, I see how this works. So you see these rack mount ears here, these have a hole in the middle, and so what you do is you line up that hole inside these notches on the back here. So these go in like so, and then you screw it in the side. Oh, yeah, right there. Look at that. You push it all the way in, and it lines right up. And so now this can be wall-mounted just like so. That's really cool. Yeah, that's a good design. I like that. All right, let's get this thing plugged in, because I know everyone wants to see the Etherlighting. All right. Power goes into the power brick, and power brick plugs into the switch. Oh, there we go. Beautiful. Look at that. I'm going to put this up a little bit. And there we can see our Etherlighting boot up sequence, the old Knight Rider boot up sequence. Oh man, I love these things so much. You know, I'm in the process of redoing my own home network to 10 gigabit, get myself up to like 10 gigabit, some better switches. I've been on like 1 gigabit forever. And as part of that upgrade, I'll have a video out on it in a couple weeks, but as part of that upgrade, I was going to use the Pro Max 24 PoE switch, but honestly, I don't need that many ports, so I think I'm just gonna use this one instead. This is a nicer form factor. I'm still gonna rack mount it, but since I don't need all the ports, I mean, this is great. Okay, while this is booting up, we should see the final sequence here in a second. I'm going to cross-connect it over here to my UDM Pro Max. All right, we're gonna plug it in just like that. We can see it just lit up right there. And now let's get into UniFi and get this thing adopted. Okay, so I am in UniFi and we can see that I have ready to add USW Pro Max 16 PoE. We're gonna say add. And that is now adopting. All right, so adopted successfully. It's up to date. Let's take a look at the details here. So USW Pro Max 16, we can see the little Etherlighting in the icon right here. And then we could see SFP Plus. We could see our 2.5 gigabit ports. Oh, and then as far as PoE Plus, okay, so it looks like also on the PoE, so these last four ports here are PoE Plus and 2.5 gigabit. So perfect for something like the U7 Pro, right? The rest of these ports are standard PoE or PoE Plus, which is 802.3 AF and AT, plus 1 gigabit only. If we come over here to settings, we can set the name. We can set the Etherlighting to the speed of the port or the VLAN, the network of that port. And because it has the Etherlighting, we can set the colors of these ports as well. So for example, gigabit, maybe we want to be green, and 2.5 gigabit, maybe we want to be red. And let's apply that change, and it should change this port to from white to red here. Oh no, it's connected at gigabit, so it changed it to green, right? That's what it should be. All right. And then it says breathing mode. So determines whether Etherlighting ports show a breathing effect. That's the sort of slow pulsing effect that you get on these ports, or you can disable that, and I think they would just be lit up solid. And other than that, I mean, this is a very standard switch setup, a very standard UniFi switch setup. All right, let's take a look at the rack mount accessory as well. Kind of a big box. Okay, so we got some sort of bracket there. That's probably one side of the rack mount. Here's the other side of the rack mount. Then we've got a black plate of some sort. We've got some screws and cage nuts. Oh, okay. Okay, so this rack mount accessory here, I figured out how this works. This part here fits into the slots on the side of the USW Pro Max 16 PoE. So this will screw in like that. And then this piece here connects in like so, and that basically makes it the length of a standard rack, any sort of standard 19-inch rack. And of course, you've got a rack mount ear for the other side as well. Now, this section right here is for this big power brick here. So there's a hole in the back for the power to go through, and then this sits in here. I'm not gonna unplug it because I don't wanna, you know what, I will just unplug it. All right, so this goes in here like so. Whoop, there's still plastic on it. All right, so that slips in here like so, and then this can be mounted on either side of the switch. So if you want the ports, you know, on the left side or the right side, it doesn't matter, this is reversible. Then the power cord has a little channel here on both sides that basically feeds in like so, and you can route the cord up the channel, and then it wraps around these little arms right here. Of course, that looks terribly messy, but you guys get the idea. There are two little arms here you can wrap it around. You could make this look a lot neater than I'm doing right here. There you go. And now it is a 1U rack mount switch. All right, let me get this plugged back in here. What do you guys think about the USW Pro Max 16 PoE? Is this a switch that you'll buy? Are you glad that they're coming out with other Etherlighting switches that have fewer ports and are probably going to be cheaper than the 24 and 48 port versions, let me know down in the comments below. And if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my original video on the 24 port Pro Max switch with Etherlighting, and the bottom video is my recent trip to Cerro Gordo, California, where we designed a complete wireless network for a ghost town.